بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده نصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created insan for an objective. Part of this objective is to pass through dunya with the awamir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make such effort that one is saved from all the torments of the year after. فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازَ. To go directly into Jannah. Go directly to Jannah, do not pass Jahannam. Part of this journey here is to live in this dunya. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained that this dunya has different stages which you will be caught up. اِعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا لَعِبُ وَلَهُ. First, as a child grows up, he buys toys, he plays, etc. Then lahu, he grows a little bit bigger, he chats, he makes jokes with his friends. Then he gets bigger, zina. Now he needs to purify himself. Now he's looking in the mirror more. He's adjusting his clothes, he's combing his hair. Then watafakhurum bainakum. Now it's about who's better. Then takathurun fil amwali wal awlad. Whose car is more nicer, whose house is more bigger, whose bank balance is more bigger, whose job portfolio, financial portfolio is greater. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. Allah is saying, if you get caught in the strap, then you're gone. But the ghurur is deception, a con, a scam. So dunya is a scammer. Dunya is a con man out to con you for akhirat. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغُرُورِ. And Allah explains, shaitan is also a con man. So we've got the con woman, and we've got the con men. Both of them are there to scam you out of your wealth of akhirat. Dunya is not any wealth, it's insignificant. And in Arabic, the word dunya, dana yadnu, means close, eminent, it's in front of us. Akhirah is afterwards, it's going to come. So that which is close, which is eminent in front of us, a person thinks so it's close, like a mirage, kasarabim, biqi'atin. You see the mirage, you think so it's close, you go to there, it's gone. You get there, it's gone. You get there, it's gone. Like that dunya seems, I just got it. I'm just doing one more deal. I'm just getting one more position in the company. I'm just going to open one more store. I'm just going to get the next series. It's just one and one and one and one. It just carries on like that. And the other one is from Dani, which is something which is low, which is vile, which is despicable. So we've got first something which is very despicable, which you wouldn't even want to go close to, which Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was with Sahaba, and he passed by a corpse and he inquired from Sahaba, do you see any value? They said no value, that's why it's here, a corpse been dumped. Said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَلْدُّنْيَا أَهْوَنْ عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِي الشَّاتْ عَلَى أَهْلِهَا. Like how this corpse, this decrepit, decaying body, nobody will want to go close to it. Dunya is like that. It's in the eyes of Allah. So like, if only you can see the reality, but you are blinded. Somebody is selling you this dead corpse and you're buying it and you're elated. لَوْ كَانَتِ الدُّنْيَا تَعْدِلُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَاحَ بَعُودَ. Even if it was worth a wing of a mosquito, distribute from Adam alayhi salam till the day of Qiyamah, your position of this wing of a mosquito, what's left? مَا سَقَى كَافِرًا مِنْهَا شُرْبَةَ مَا. Allah would have not even given a kafir one drop of water, but Allah is giving them the gold and the diamond and the platinums of this world. Because it is not valuable, Allah is giving them. As for the people of Iman, الدُّنْيَا سِجْنُ الْمُؤْمِنُ وَجَنَّةُ الْكَافِرِ. It's a prison for the believers because Allah has kept something valuable in store for the believers. So they need to live their life like a prisoner. Not that they are prisoners, there's a difference. It is like the laws of a prisoner who's got laws, rules, restrictions, limitations. If you don't trespass those limitations, then there's freedom, there's a utopia, there's akhirah, there's jannah, there's pleasures, there's enjoyments. Another riwayat, inna atwala an-nas ju'an yawm al-qiyamah aktharuhum shib'an. Whoever satisfied their taste buds and enjoyed dunya and even went into haram consumption, they'll be more hungry. So ulama say, whoever control their nafs in this world will able to enjoy their nafs in akhirah. Whoever enjoyed their nafs, their desires in this world, then their nafs needs to be tortured in akhirah. They cannot enjoy akhirah. فَإِذَا فَارَقَ الدُّنْيَا فَارَقَ السِّجْنِ. When you leave dunya, as if you're gaining freedom from these rules, because there's unlimited freedom. Riwayat was the Hassan. فَالْمُؤْمِنْ يَتَزَوَّدْ. So a mu'min, for him, he has to abstain. وَالْكَافِرْ يَتَمَتَّعْ. And a kafir will enjoy as much as he can. Imam Ghazali said, and this is close to the qawl of Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz, that the dunya is عَدُوَّةٌ لِلَّهِ, enemy of Allah. وَعَدُوَّةٌ لِأَوْلِيَاءِ اللَّهِ, for the enemies of the friends of Allah. وَعَدُوَّةٌ لِأَدَاءِ اللَّهِ, and even the enemies of Allah, dunya is their enemy. Why? Because this dunya will separate the friends of Allah from Allah. It will deceive. فَغَمَّدْهُمْ, and it will put them into grief and anxiety, because it is a deception. وَأَمَّا أَعْدَاءُ اللَّهِ فَغَوَتْهُمْ. Even the enemies of Allah, they will suffer because of this dunya. It will take them to stages which they cannot imagine. So we've got one, غُرُور. غُرُور in Arabic is to deceive, to dazzle, to blind. So this dunya is so dazzling, it's so blinding, it's so beguiling, that it will entice a person, tempt them, seduce them to something which is valuable. You will give that away and you will exchange it. A person will sell his deen, he will sell his akhirat for something which is valueless, actually worse than that. He's exchanging it for torture and torment in akhirat. That's why it's called ghurur. How foolish can a person be? He's exchanging success in this world, in akhirah, for distress in dunya and torment in the year after. So a person gets caught up in all this deception. You see, there was a policeman who pulled over a country road. There was a roadblock, so he stopped the lady, and after following her, he said, explain yourself, you've been driving very erratically. You were weaving all over the road, this side, that side. What's wrong? So she said, thank goodness, oh officer, you really saved me from an accident. It's good that I stopped. Everywhere I was driving, I seen a tree in front of me. I swerved left, I seen a tree. I swerved right, I seen a tree. Everywhere I was swerving, I seen a tree. It was a terrifying and disastrous experience. So the officer looked inside, he looked on the rear view mirror and he said, yes madam, there was a tree, I can guarantee you that. It was your air freshener. It was your air freshener. So sometimes this dunya is in front of us, it moves our vehicle of akhirat, that we don't see the haqiqat. And if a person doesn't see the reality of dunya, then he can meet up in an accident, because things go out of control, where a person compromises his deen, compromises his salat, compromises his tilawat. That a person doesn't even know what deception he's in. As a lady, the wife came to the husband, she said, the car won't start, but I've identified the problem. So he said, you identifying the problem? She said, yes, I know what's the problem. So he said, what's the problem? Shocked. She said, there's a problem with the carburetor. There's water in the carburetor. So he said, you don't know anything about cars. How do you know there's water in the carburetor? She said, go check, I guarantee you there's water in the carburetor. So he went to go check, he found the car in the pool. He found the car in the pool. So if we don't get it right now, then there's a possibility a person is going into destruction. So we have to actually identify the problem and identify Deen is my solution and I need to change my life. Because if a person continues involving himself in dunya, he will think so he's solving a problem. So much dhoka, so much discipline, a person will think so he's solving the problem, but he's not solving the problem, he's exacerbating the problem. You thought so you solve it, more money, you thought so you solve it, go into this. But the more he goes into it, the more his problems increase. Because our solutions are not on the earth, it's in the Asman. There were passengers on the plane, it was delayed for a while. They were stressed and worried and concerned and frustrated. Eventually the plane took off. So one of the passengers got the air hostess alone and asked her that, you know what was this problem with the flight? We left so late and I've got so much appointments, etc. So the stewardess said that the pilot was worried. He heard a noise in the engine and he was quite concerned about it. So it took us a long time to find a new pilot. So we're solving the problem, but we're not solving the problem. Because where it's supposed to be solved, we're not looking there. وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ Look to Allah, we will solve our problems. And when the crunch comes and when we test it and a person fails, وَإِنَّهُ عَلَىٰ ذَلِكَ لَشَهِيدٌ He knows, I have to turn to Allah. But what's his problem? وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَدِيدٌ This dunya has deceived him. It's taken him out of the reality. Such a deception that a person doesn't realize. He'll sell his iman, he'll sell his deen, he'll sell. One youngster blackmail his father, if I don't get the brand new BM by Monday morning, I'll report you to the receiver of revenue. One son planned an assassination of his parents because he had them insured for high value. So, a person will sell everything, they will compromise even their deen. One farmer once went to a fair, he seen a helicopter there, they never rode ever in their life, it was $150, they went questioned, they said $150. So the pilot looked at them, old people, he said, is there a problem? He said, yes, we can't afford it, we'll never afford it. So he thought, so these old people are going to die one day, let me give them an opportunity. He said, I'll take you for a ride, but you must not scream, make a sound. So they agreed. He said, if you make a sound, you pay me $150. If you don't make a sound, it's free. They agreed. They went on to the ride and he tried whatever he could. No noise came. So he looked at the back. He said, okay, I'm going to give you $300 now, but I'm going to take you for a thrill of a lifetime. Don't make a sound. So they agreed. Anyway, he tried everything he could. He failed. As they were landing, he said, you know, I'm quite impressed that you people have managed. He said it was quite a close call. He said, yes, I know. The pilot, yes, I know. He said, forget a close call. I nearly said something when my wife fell out. He said, your wife fell out. Why didn't you tell me? He said, $300 is $300. $300 is $300. So dunya will overtake a person. No matter what, whatever situation is, a person will try. And like we said, dunya is the con woman, shaitan is the con man, and every second of the 24 hours of our day, every second of our lifetime, they're out there to trap us. They say once the husband came home, he found the wife painting the car blue. She divided it, so she made one side blue and one the original color, bright yellow. So he said, what are you doing? Is there something wrong with you? So he became crazy. He said, no. She told him that there's a wisdom and hikmat in this year. So she said, you know what, let me tell you. She said, how can there be wisdom of painting the car two colors? She said, listen. So he said, okay, tell me. She said, you see, I've had so many accidents and I get caught due to the witnesses and the statements and then we end up paying a lot of money. The insurance company doesn't pay and we're going in debt. I found a solution. She said, when there's ever an accident next time, we'll ask them what color what color car caused the accident? What was the color of the car that caused the accident? They say, if you can't beat them, confuse them. Is the English saying, if you can't beat them, confuse them. If Shaitan can't beat us, they'll confuse us. And even in halat and conditions that come, whether it's tsunamis, whether it's diseases, whether it's whatever else it is, a person doesn't go back in time and realize that I need to change my life. I need to make a decision. The one driver was speeding in a countryside. As he took the bend, he seen two workers, farm workers, standing in the middle of the road. So they're farm workers, they don't expect any traffic. So he was going to hit them, and as he came close, he had to swerve. He avoided them, ran up the embankment, he somersaulted a few times, and in the field where they normally work, he landed up there. So the one worker told the other worker, as he was standing in the middle of the road, he said, we were so lucky, it's good we got out of the field just in time. It's good we got out of the field just in time. You are the problem. Where are you seen? Where is your gaze? You're still carrying on your disobedience. You're still carrying on that same fikr, that same life, that same routine. Such a deception. When will a person get out of it? When the angel of death comes, you say, there was one lion. He woke up in the morning, he got hidayat. He realized, hey, you know what, I need to show my authority and my power. So he decided to go to the animals of the jungle. He passed the monkey and he roared, who is the mightiest animal of the jungle? The monkey was shivering and he said, you are the mighty lion. Then he came across another animal, a fox. He said, who is the mightiest animal in the jungle? As he roared, the fox started trembling and shaking. And he said, you are the king of the jungle. Then the lion met the elephant. And he asked him the same question, who is the mightiest animal of the jungle? Roared the lion. The elephant grabbed the lion with his trunk, slammed him against the ground, slammed him on the tree, and threw him far in the long distance. The lion was ruffled and injured, and he screamed with a loud voice, all right, if you don't know the answer, there's no need to become nasty. If you don't know the answer, there's no need to become nasty. So when will we see the reality? After how many shots? After how many knocks? How long will we carry on this deception and this dhoka of this dunya? So a person needs to take lesson from the conditions, from the situations, realize the hakikat and the reality, and start changing. And now's the time, not tomorrow, not next week, not whenever. We need to make a niyat that now's the time to change. Allah has given me breath, Allah has given me life, Allah has given me health, Allah has given me an opportunity. Let us make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amongst the adiyah, morning and evening, which Nabi alayhi salam used to read, was three times. Morning and evening, if we can read it. Otherwise, worst case in the morning. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi adada khalqihi wa rida nafsihi wa zinata arshihi wa midada kalimatihi. Nabi alayhi salam left in the morning and late afterwards he returned. One of his azwaje mutahharat, Hazrat Juwayriya radiallahu anha, was still at the musalla. So from the time early morning till later after the sun had risen, Nabi alayhi salam seen her sitting there, and he said, I have said four kalimat three times. It is equivalent to the ibadah that you made this entire morning. So let us try to make amal on that. And now is the ayyam abith, 13, 14 and 15th of every month. It is sunnah to fast on these days. If we never got a chance, let us make a niyat. If we can't all 3 days, 2 days, if we can't one day, and now it is Saturday, Sunday, Monday, we'll be making amal on the fast of Monday as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of making amal. Wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.